Hey traders, welcome back to the channel. In this video, we're going to talk about the Ashford Hospitality Trust, ticker symbol AHT. After a pretty disappointing day, closing down 5%, coming out with so-so earnings yesterday after hours, and really just a roller coaster of the day. So we're going to quickly look at earnings and then go and break down the chart to figure out what we can expect next. So without any further ado, let's hop right into the analysis. All right, so here we have a quick recap of what came out with earnings yesterday. As you can see, the EPS did end up beating by 43 cents. Meanwhile, revenue missed by $5 million. So earnings. However, you know, we talked about this stock over the weekend. We see that there is a massive upside, and yet the stock was down today. So I just pretty much want to focus on the chart for the rest of the video. And here we have the daily chart for AHT. As you can see, it started off down. It fell all the way into the 290s, but then we had a pretty nice bounce going. We got over the VWAP, retested it, and then bounced and actually bounced above this 320 resistance zone that we talked about over the weekend before kind of falling back down, falling under that. And then starting a downtrend. Now, this is actually kind of where I started watching to pick up a position. You know, we had this downtrend going and then we actually broke out of it right here. So that's right where I entered, right in that 292 mark. And it looked good for a minute. You know, we had this big 290 support zone under it. However, then we broke out of this uptrend and then we started battling with the 290 and we unfortunately fell through that for kind of reclaiming ourselves right around that 282 support zone. And we just oscillated there for the rest of the day. I am still holding my position. I do believe in the long-term outlook. However, we do have to be very, very careful in this range. I'm going to tell you exactly what I'm watching. But first, let's go over some indicators. As you can see here, this yellow line represents the VWAP, the volume weighted average price. And like we talked about, AHT did end up falling below the VWAP for pretty much the entirety of the afternoon. It closed below VWAP, which does mean the bears are in control heading into tomorrow's trading session. However, a few other indicators I personally like to use as a trader. First, we can take a look at this light blue line. That is the 50-day SMA. Being above that means we are in bullish territory in the intermediate term. And as we can see, we are still holding above that. It's going to act as kind of a key support level moving forward. Another one, kind of a shorter level moving average right here, is the 21-day EMA. It's sitting at 253. So you can see in the short to intermediate term, things are actually looking pretty bullish. You know, the stock did still have a pretty nice move up last week and might just be in a consolidation zone. But that's why we got to look at the key support and resistance levels. So, you know, right here, you have the first big support level is going to be at that 282 and all the way to 280 range. So this entire thing is kind of going to serve as a support zone. However, if we break under that, you know, we're not going to see much support until 266. So breaking under this could mean we kind of have a break in the bigger picture uptrend and we may have to start consolidating. This would be the first zone we would expect consolidation at. So if you are looking to go long in the stock, keep in mind that if this does not hold, then the 266 area would be a good spot to maybe start adding. You know, it's low risk, high upside. However, if things do reverse tomorrow and we do start breaking towards the upside, here's what we have to keep in mind as far as resistance zones. The first one's going to be right here, that 290 marker. It held pretty strong, you know, throughout the day. We started off by testing it. We were able to bounce above it. We retested it here, bounced above it. Unfortunately, it did break through. So now that's going to be a very big resistance zone. If we can get above that, you know, into tomorrow morning, things are going to start to turn and look a little bit more bullish. After that, we have this big 320 zone. We tried making a move on it today. It unfortunately did not work out. And then as we talked about in this weekend's video, after that, we're going to see resistance zones at 376 and 420. And if we can get above those, you know, we should have a pretty clean shot to $5. That is still my long-term target on this stock. But short-term, yeah, we are really looking for this 280 to 282 support zone to hold, because if not, we may be looking at a bigger reset, a bigger consolidation before making the next step upward. So let me know whether you agree, whether you disagree, if you are long on the stock right now and believe we will get that turnaround tomorrow, or whether you think there is some more downside ahead. If you like this video, make sure to leave a thumbs up. And if you want to see more content like this, please subscribe to the channel. Aside from that, have a great rest of your night.